श्रीमती रमन जर्मा। In this vast, ever growing, ever advancing, relentlessly developing world, innumerable phases and transitions of knowledge, expectations, ambitions, and converging technologies have given the rise. In this advent, there must be a standard science and technology, there must be a standard spirit, which has culminated into various these forms which are existing now and which are yet to be developed. And that is what we want to say: imagination, creativity, animation, and multimedia. In each and every walk of life, in each and every stage of universal development and civilization of mankind, everything was inceptively conceptualized, visualized, materialized, communicated, then crafted and drafted in technological and tactical forms and put into practical usage. Setting into a relentless race of development and advancement today is based on these things only. God created everything by his imagination. But that is not a fertile, groundless, baseless, mean imagination which artistic people and hypnotic people used to imagine about themselves and other things. It is a framed, well-structured, symbolic, multi-dimensional, and it is something cognitive. In Shastra they used to call it sankalpa, and in English it is known as cognitive. It is a cognitive designing skill and will of God by which he has fashioned the universe. So the same world, it has come into existence. The mankind and evolution of species, they have been fashioned and designed. And the civilization era of human being that started with inhabitation, domestication, accustomation, mechanization, sensing and artificial intelligence, different phases of this knowledge, everything has passed these four major steps. One is by means of imagination. Just to imagine what you want to become. Imagine what you are. Imagine what are the deficiencies. Imagine about a comparative scale of efficiency with your deficiency. So this type of a multifaceted and multidimensional imagination is the starting point. Anybody's imbibition or exposure to the world, it starts with a curious spirit. It is known as a spark. This spark of zeal or curiosity to know, to be, to become, to want, to add or to subtract, whatever it may be. This curiosity is driven by a spirit known as imagination. Curiosity plus imagination gives you visualization, conceptualization and materialization of things. And these things are the very basic network of the global existence. We need not think that multimedia or visualization or creativity is very much exclusive to computer-aided tools or connected with the games or entertainments or sports or interactive industries. It is a common frame of the whole world. God, he had the primitive design or the primordial design or the eternal design of the world. As he is omniscient, as he is perspicacious, as he is clairvoyant and multidimensionally cognitive and hypnotic, he could able to visualize the world by his imagination, and he processes the same thing. So the basic skill is imagination. Imagination is the germination for the curiosity to get into things, number one. Second, imagination is different from creativity. If there is a source, it is known as imagination. If the source gets a shape, it is known as visualization. If the shape gets the solution, that is creativity. Most of the people can imagine, but few of them are creative. Creativity is advanced imagination. Creativity is productive imagination. Creativity is applied imagination. Imagination about impossibilities. Imagination about incorporatabilities of one's own self suiting to the environment, to his future and nature, that should be laid down with proper principles and boundaries. So this type of imaginations, which has no foundation, no pillars, no vidhana. What we call, what is vidhana? Vidhana is the substratum. It should have a substratum, a base, a foundation. It should have a filler. It should have a conway. It should have prapurna, what we call purti. It should have, see, if you have an imagination that you want to become an engineer, it should have a filler. It should be filled with enthusiasm, capability, your involvement, exercises, practical behavior, association and everything. So otherwise, it is a hollow pipe. Imagination is a hollow pipe. Each and every effort of you to fructify the imagination is known as a filler, it is known as purna. And the process is known as purana. Purana is the process, and a person who is well processed is known as purna. So imagination is the source of activity or dynamism. And if you give a shape, that is known as visualization. In addition to that, if it results in solution, it is known as creativity. Most of the people, they are having the problem because they are having more imagination than even scientists. There are three people who imagine more with creativity. God is a very good imaginer. He is having a very good imaginary machinery. Great scientists, for example, if I see a tree, as a botanist, I can deeply think about it. As a farmer, I can deeply think about it. As a biotechnologist, I can think about it. As a poet, I can think about it. As a lover of nature, I can think about it. So as a scientist, as a social person, as an environmentalist, as a specific analyst known as a botanist, or a scientist about the seed or root mechanics or plant genetics or anything, we can deal with that. So approaching a thing that makes a deeper thought in various areas. If I am functionally analyzing it, I am a scientist. If I am structurally analyzing it for comparative, competitive and conservative studies, I am a poet. If I am understanding to create an imaginary, imitative pratirupa or an image form for that by means of either various pravritti we used to call. Vag is vocal or verbal exposition. Chitra is pictorial exposition. Prayantrika is known as technical exposition. If I am doing it in graphics, then I am technically exposing the same thing. If I am drawing that by Chitrakala, I am pictorially or depictively doing the same thing. If I am analyzing the functions of the same thing, then certainly that exposure that makes me to become a very great scientist pertaining to the plant botany or some specific unit of the same art. But if I am comparing with it of the elegance, the majesty, the beauty, the tenderness and delicacy of the plants and that of the peripheral joy, comfort, consolation, solace and various elements that are reproduced in our mental frame, then I am a poet, I am a nature lover. So this type of creativity is with all people. Any person, just a person even getting the shade and shadow of the tree to take rest, till the person who consumes it as a consumer, as a farmer, as an irrigator, as a nourisher, as a lover, as an analyzer, as a deep introspector, innumerable people they approach the same thing in different modes, out of which multimedia is also, this type of art is also a part of it. So unless these technically embedded multimedia people, they don't have the inner spirit of having the multilateral and compositive way of understanding the nature and enjoying it, mere technical operators or simulators or switch on and switch off service providers for those meetings, then that is too insufficient.